Hey, SureCallers and Certified Installers, thanks for joining us again. In this video, we're talking about free space path loss. So what is it exactly? Well, let's dive in. If you remember from our earlier videos, loss, which results from a decrease in wave amplitude, has a negative impact on the strength of your signal, whereas gain, which is caused by an increase in wave amplitude, positively impacts your signal strength. Now, free space path loss is something that a lot of people don't think about when determining how much coverage a signal booster can provide in a building, home, or vehicle. Free space path loss is a weakening of the RF signal due to a broadening of the wave. This broadening of the RF wave is known as signal dispersion, or beam divergence. As a radio wave travels further from its point of origin, the wave broadens, which causes it to get weaker. You can think of it like ripples in water. The further the ripple travels, the weaker the waves get. Atmosphere has the same effect on radio waves. Free space path loss is not linear. It's based on the frequency, amplitude, and the distance of the wave. For example, if you're using a Force 5 signal booster with a donor signal of negative 80 dBm and a single indoor antenna, you'll get about 50 decibels of free space path loss by the time you're 20 feet away from the indoor antenna. Pretty significant, right? So how do you minimize free space path loss? First, choosing a booster kit that offers the most output power will be the way to go. Second, during installation, you'll want to see max gain on your signal meter when you plug into the connector at the end of your cable run. And third, place your indoor antenna in the location where you most often use your mobile device to eliminate space between you and the source of the boosted signal. Thanks for watching, and if you've got more questions, let us know in the comments. And if you like this video, subscribe to our channel and have a look at these videos to learn more about similar topics.